This was great yesterday. If you grew up in the late 60s, 70s, or 80s, it would have been hard to turn the TV or radio on and not see and hear Tony Orlando. So Tony is 79 years old now and is taking the stage one last time this Friday night at Mohegan Sun. We got a chance to catch up with Tony yesterday, and he truly is such a good guy. I am so happy to be standing here with you today. I truly am. Growing up as a kid, you couldn't turn the TV on, you couldn't turn the radio on without hearing your music or seeing you on TV. That's got to mean something.
It means a lot to me, I can tell you that it affected you that way. I mean, that's the thing about this wonderful journey I've been on. I have had people walk up to me with their grandchildren and say, I want you to know, I told my grandchild all about you when I did this and that, I met. And then I just can't believe that six decades have happened to me already and that it may have affected someone like you doing broadcasting so well and being so successful. And you have that little starry-eyed look like you were a kid again, and you don't know what that does for the old man here. That makes me feel like, yes! I did a movie with Adam Sandler. It was called That's My Boy. So anybody under 55, mostly under 30 especially, have no idea that Yellow Ribbon, Knock Three Times, Gypsy Rose, He Don't Love You Like I Love You, you know, they don't know all the Candida. They have no idea that these millions of records I had anything to do with. In fact, they couldn't even sing the song to you, okay? But they'll walk up to me, I swear, and I tell this to Adam all the time. My career comes down to one word from that movie. Do you know what it is? Okay, here it is. It's a scene I do with Adam, right?
Yep.
So the young person will walk up to me and go, I know you. What up? Which is the one word in that movie. So I called Adam up. I said, Adam, 70 million records, okay? I had my own television show, right? Three Grammy nominations, three American Music Awards, all this stuff, right? It all came down to your one word in your movie, what's up, my whole career, to this 20-year-old. And it just shows you, you can't take fame seriously.
So Friday night is going to be you're calling it the finale. And I'm sure that was not something you took lightly, saying, okay, I'm going to step away from this. But you're saying you're retiring. That is not really what's going on here.
Yeah.
You have a ton of other things that you're working on.
Other things?
Yes.
But it's my retirement from what I've known since I'm 16.
Right.
All I have known is being a live entertainer. That's all I've ever known. I started with Carole King in 1961, number one record, Halfway to Paradise. All I've known is get dressed, do the show, get dressed, do the show, get on the bus, do the show, get on the plane, do the show. You know, I'm going to be 80, 79 years old. It's time. Mm-hmm. And all of the components that make why it's time, you guys already know. It's the traveling, it's this, it's that. Change in the business, it's all of that stuff. And you have to be wise and realistic about it. The one thing I'm going to miss is the people.
Does your beautiful wife, Fran, have a list of things for you to do while you're retiring?
Unfortunately, yes. We won't even go there. here's one of them, okay? He's home.
He was such a good guy yesterday.
Awesome.
And, you know, I was saying this morning and even just last night, when you meet somebody and you actually feel good about being with them and then leaving with them, he's genuinely just a good man, does a ton of stuff with veterans and has for such a long time, and said he has no plans on stopping doing that. But he wants to, you know, he's got a book, he's got a play he's writing, and he wants to just... He's 79.
I was going to say, he wants to retire.
He wants to retire.
Good for him.
Yeah.
And his wife's got some stuff for him to do.
She's
around the house.
I mean, spoken like a true wife,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
It's just remarkable when you look at the career that he's had. And, you know, Will was telling me, because we like all that old talk show stuff,
sure.
The Tonight Show, and the things he was saying yesterday about those days.
Yeah, he was talking about doing the telethons with Jerry Lewis and, you know, the Tonight Show and being around all of these people. And not even just interviewing, but I could have sat there, like you could have sat there and just listened to him. I was ready to invite him out to Twin Oaks for like
a
You
should
because
have.
We got along that way.
We would have gone. But I have to say, I do agree with our director Eric was saying in our ear. He did say 55, 45. I'm 46.
Right.
You know, I remember him.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
sure.
I mean, I think that, you know.
And, you know, I'm no expert, but I think he resembles Joe Zito a little bit.
He kind of does.
TV Maitre D.
The two,
has anyone ever seen them in the same place?
He kind of does.
But that is fantastic.
What a great interview. He seems so nice.
Yeah, he was a really
kind.
really just a good man last night. So happy retirement to Tony. So if you want to see Tony sing one last time, and he said he means it, we're going to post the link on our website, and that's roadshow.com.